Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the previous lecture, you have learned about the beams, types of beams, and the shear force and bending moment. Now we will solve a problem related to that, in which we will find out how to draw the bending moment diagram and the shear force diagram. So for that, we have a simple beam, in which at point A and at point C, two loads have been applied. To counter these loads, we have two reaction forces at point B and at point D. The required data, we have to find the reaction forces RB and RD. Second, we have to find the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Coming towards the solution of the problem, calculation of reaction forces. Now, in order to find the reaction forces, I will apply the equilibrium condition that the summation of all the forces should equal to zero. That is, summation of forces along y direction should be equal to zero, and I am taking my own convention that the upward forces, I will take them as a positive, and the downward forces I will take it as negative. Now if we see that at point A, 20 kilonewton force is applied, and the direction of this force is downward, so I will take this as a negative because of my own convention. So this force will be minus 20 kilonewton. Second, at point B, there is an reaction force which is in opposite direction, so I will take this reaction force as positive, so I will write it RB. Third, at point C, again this force is acting downward, so I will take this force as plus 40 kilonewton. Sorry, minus 40 kilonewton. At point D, this force is acting in upward direction, so I will take this as plus. So it will be RD, which is equal to zero. Now rearranging the equation, so RB plus RD will be equal to 20 plus 40, it will be equal to 60 kilonewton, and this is my equation number first. Now in the second part, I will find the moments. So for that, I will apply the equilibrium condition that the summation of all the moments should be equal to zero. So you can take the moment at any point. You can take it at point B, or you can take it at point D. So I am taking the moments at point B. So the summation of all the moment at point B should be equal to zero. Now I am taking my own convention that the clockwise moment, I will take it positive, and the anti-clockwise moments I will take it negative. So if we look at point A, this force will create a moment in the counter clockwise direction. So I will take this moment as negative, and the distance between point A and B is 2.5 meter. The distance between B and C is 3 meter, and the distance between C and D is 2 meter. Now if we look at point A, this 20 kilonewton force will create a moment which will be in a counterclockwise direction. So I will take this moment as negative. So kilonewton multiplied by the direction, the distance between A and B, which is 2.5 meter. Now at point C, this force will create moment in the clockwise direction. So I will take this moment as positive, that is plus 40 kilonewton multiplied by the distance between B and C, that is 3 meter. Now at point D, this force will create a moment in the anti-clockwise direction. So I will take this moment as negative, so it will be minus RD into the distance between point B and point D, that is 5 meter, which equal to 0. Now 20 kilonewton into 2.5 will be equal to 50 kilonewton meter plus 40 into 3, it will become 120 kilonewton meter minus RD into 5 meter, H is equal to 0. Rearranging the equation, minus RD into 5 meter equal to minus 120 plus 50. Minus RD into 5 meter, from this it will become minus 70 kilo newton meter. Divide both sides by 5 meter. So it will cancel out, it will become minus RD, and this will become minus 14 kilo newton. So RD will become 14 kilo newton. Now putting this value, the value of RD, in equation number 1, which is RB plus RD equal to 60 kilo newton. RB, putting the value of RD, which is plus 14 kilo newton equal to 60 kilo newton. From this RB will become 46 kilo newton. So we have find the reaction forces. Now, the second part is to find shear forces. For that, the step number two, calculation of shear forces. Now, for the calculation of shear forces, I will divide the beam into different sections. So, I will take my own convention that suppose this is my section. To the right of the left of the section, I will and if the force is in upward direction, and to the right of the section, if the force is in downward direction, I will take this as positive. And if to the left of the section, if the the force is in downward direction, and to the right of the section, if the force is in upward direction, I will take it negative. So now I am dividing this beam into different sections. So first I will divide this section. I will take a section closer to A, point A. So this is my section. Now if you look to the left of this section, there is only one force which is acting in downward direction. And I said that if a force is acting in downward direction, and if it is in the left side of the section, I will take it negative. So shear force at A, point A, it is in downward direction and to the left of the section, so I will take it negative. It will become minus 20 kilo Newton. Shear force at point B. Now I am taking another section nearer to point B. Now if you see that to the left of the section, there are two forces acting. One is at point A and the other is at point B. Now at point A, if you see that this force is acting in downward direction, so I will take this force as minus 20 kilonewton. And we have found already that this force RB is 46 kilonewton. Now if you see to the left of the section, this force is acting in upward direction, and I said that if the force is acting in the upward direction and it is to the left of the section, I will take it plus, so it will become plus 46 kilo Newton. So it will become 26 kilo Newton. Shear force at B. Now shear force at C. Now I will take another section nearer to point C. Again apply the same conditions. If you now there are three forces acting in the left of the section. So I will take this force as negative because it is in downward direction, so it will become minus 20 kilonewton. This force is acting in upward direction, so I will take it plus 46 kilonewton. And this force is acting in downward direction, so again I will take it as negative, so it will become minus 40 kilonewton. So it will become minus 14 kilonewton. Now shear force at point D. So I will take another section to the right of the point D, and we already calculated that the reaction force at point D is 14 kilonewton. So if you see to the right of the section, there is only one force is acting, which is 14 kilonewton, and this force is acting in upward direction. If a force is acting in upward direction and it is to the right of the plane, I will take it as negative. So this force will become minus 14 kilonewton. So we have calculated the shear force. Now the third step is step number 2. Now step number 3, calculation of bending moments. So for in order to calculate the bending moments, so I will take sections as I took in the calculation of shear force. So I will take section that if this force create a moment in clockwise direction and it is to the left of the section, and if force is creating a moment and which is in counter clockwise direction and it is to the right of the section, I will take it positive. And if a force is acting and it produces a moment which is acting counterclockwise to the left of the section, I will take it negative. If a force is acting on a beam and it produces a moment and it produces a moment in the clockwise direction, and if it is to the right of the section, I will take it minus negative. So now I will do the same as I did in the calculation of the shear force. So I will calculate the bending moment at point A, point B, point C and point D. As you know that at the bending moment, at point A and at point D, it is zero because it is overhanging beam. You have already learned about the beams and types of beam. If a beam is overhanging beam, so at the tip of the beam, the bending moment will be equal to zero. So now I will find the bending moment at point B, and point C. So now at point B, the bending moment at point B, bending moment will be, I am taking this section, there are two forces acting in the left of the section. This section, this force will create the moment in the counterclockwise direction, and it is to the left of the section. So I will take it negative, so this will become minus 20 into the distance between point A and B, 2.5, which is 50 minus 50 kilo Newton meter. At point C, now I am taking this section, there are now to the left of this section there are three forces acting. This force will create moment in the clockwise direction, and it is to the left of the section, so I will take it as negative, so minus 20 kilonewton multiplied by the distance between point A and C, that is 2.5 plus 3, that is 5.5 meter. Now at point B, this force will create a moment in the anti-clockwise direction, and it is also to the left of the plane, so I will take it minus 46. The distance between point B and C is 3 meter. Now